Hello there, a very good morning. You're watching Proactive London and from Galliford Try this morning to discuss your trading update. It's Andrew Duxbury. Warm welcome to you because today we're discussing, as I say, the trading update and a bit of a forecast into 2022 as well. But before we do that, what we'll do is we'll take this opportunity, Andrew, for you to give us an introduction to the firm for those people who aren't already in the know.
Okay, thanks. Morning again, Katie. Nice to speak to you again. So Galliford Try is a UK-wide construction business. We operate across Scotland and England, really delivering the economic and social infrastructure that the UK needs. So our key sectors are education, healthcare, water, highways. And I think what really sets us apart is we're a very people-orientated business. We're driven by our values, and that really allows us to focus on delivering for all of our stakeholders. We're a very well-capitalised business. We've got a really strong balance sheet, excellent cash position. We can talk about that in a moment. Mm-hmm. And we're really focused on risk management as part of our delivery of our sustainable growth strategy that we set out in September of 2021.
All right. You mentioned the cash position. So we'll talk about that in just a second because we're going to talk about the trading update and the details in that, which you have published this morning. So maybe just give us sort of the key takeaways, if you would.
Yeah, I will do, of course. So we've published a trading update for the 6 months through to the 31st of December 2021. And overall, the group is performing really well in line with the board's expectations and progressing nicely in line with the strategic growth objectives that we set out last year. We've made some really good operational progress in the 6 months, and this latest COVID variant hasn't really disrupted the business at all. We've continued to work really well with our supply chain, and that active engagement with the supply chain has really helped us to mitigate the issues around inflation and material availability and so on, which you'll have read about last autumn. So those issues have had no impact on the business in the 6 months. We delivered in that 6 months, our average month-end cash was £180 million. That's increased from last year, and an excellent performance. And our order book also increased to £3.4 billion. And behind that, there's a further pipeline of really strong opportunities. So there's some sectors that we've got some really good track record of success in. And those are the sectors where we see really strong government investment coming through, that economic and social infrastructure. So we see a really good pipeline of opportunities beyond that £3.4 billion order book.
Mm-hmm. And talking of opportunities, maybe take us through some of the recent contract wins, if you would, Andrew.
Yeah, of course. Well, look, in the last 6 months, I guess the key thing first to touch on is the acquisition that we made. We acquired the water business of NMCN. NMCN, unfortunately, had fallen into administration. We managed to buy their water business and bring the people with it. That gave us some really excellent geographic coverage in the water sector. It also brought with it some really excellent capabilities around process and design and offsite build, and as well a really great quality a team of people came with the business. So that acquisition has been really, really good for the business and has really bedded in well into Galliford Try. Aside from that, we talked in the autumn about education being one of our key sectors to delivering our growth strategy. And within education, we've been appointed to the four-year education construction framework. That's the main education procurement, so the main way that they'll procure new schools across mm-hmm. England. We've been appointed to that framework to deliver schools across all regions of England. And at the same time, our Scottish business, Morrison Constructions, continue to be really successful in education. They've been appointed to the £55 million Galashiels Community Campus. That will deliver around 1,000 places, education places in Scotland. And another sector, just to give you an example, we talked about in the autumn was the private rented housing sector. This is somewhere that we see really good growth opportunities, and we've just been appointed to a £56 million scheme in Milton Keynes that will deliver around 330 new houses in Milton Keynes. So those are some really good examples of the kind of work we've been winning in the 6 months, all of which are really aligned to the strategy and to the sectors that we set out when we put our growth strategy out last year.
Mm-hmm. And what do you want people watching this to take away from it, Andrew?
I think the really key takeaway is we're making some really good progress against our strategic objectives. We've got a really strong platform to deliver sustainable growth. And what I mean by that is a really strong order book, a really strong balance sheet and the cash position that I mentioned. We've got a really great quality of people across the country, across all parts of our business. I guess the next thing is that we really see the drivers for growth. So we'll see opportunities for growth across all of our sectors. So those sectors that we're focused on are the sectors where we see the government investing more to rebuild the UK's economic and social infrastructure. And I guess the final thing I'd draw out is really is our approach to sustainability. So sustainability really at the heart of everything that we do. And what that means is that allows us to deliver for all of our stakeholders, whether that be investors, the communities we work in, the clients that we're working with, delivering on our net zero carbon ambitions that we launched last year. And really what that means is that we really can make sure that we deliver the 5-year financial targets that we set out in September of 2021.
All right, Andrew Duxbury, thank you very much. From Galliford Try, talking about your trading update this morning here on Proactive.
Okay, thanks very much, Katie.